getting started in just 1 second. We have our judges here over to my left. I'm not a Frenchman, but I'll do my best. Benjamin Cloquet. Good enough? All right. And also, we have everybody's pretty familiar with Eric, obviously, here. David Charlefield, formerly from TechCrunch, and Mr. Guru in the middle there. So we have our three judges. I'm your MC in a couple of ways. And I'll also be judging. And we're trying to make this as exciting as possible, but also we're looking for great innovation and great ideas and great startups. So with that being said, give you the format. So just so everybody understands, you may have not been here earlier, each company will have 2 minutes to present, and we'll have 10 minutes of questions, no Q&A. 4 companies will be presenting per hour, and then 8 companies will be presenting today. And this is the entertainment category, and we'll invite 3 companies back to present on Tuesday. All right, so with that being said, let's get it started. We want to welcome the first company to the stage, and that is Tugg.
Yeah. general, right?
Sure.
There was this idea that you could demand for a artist, you know, if I want an MC Hammer to come to my small town, I can sort of create a demand for it, and if I got, you know, enough people to make it worth his while, then he'd show up.
And there's still the question of whether someone is going to show up. People are committing with their credit cards as they're pre-purchasing these tickets. So we authorize the funds. We don't capture them. We only capture them in the case that the event threshold is actually reached.
What do you guys use for your ticket platform? Are you developing that yourselves, or you don't?
We're developing it ourselves. For many of our theater partners, which include AMC, Regal, Cinemark, Parade, Goodrich, so we have a pretty much at least 60% of the theater footprint in the country already covered. We do partner with companies that facilitate ticketing for them as well, just because it's a better platform to go beyond just the immediate social networks that are actually achieving these thresholds, and allow other members of the community to gain visibility to that event.
From a consumer standpoint, you're making the assumption that consumers want to watch a movie in the local theater instead of the comfort of their own homes. Do you have any research that might be helpful, or any consumer insight on this?
Yeah, so obviously it is known within the film industry that any film that has a theatrical release always performs better in DVD as well. So there's great motivation for filmmakers and distributors to always have at least a theatrical run for the film. Filmmakers never made or intended to make films to be watched on an iPhone. Every filmmaker wants that theatrical release, and not only film lovers, but most people share or have a consensus that the best place to experience a film for the first time, at least, is in a big screen in a darker room.
Just to follow up on that, so it's about new release or it's about library?
We're working with a new release, for example, from Paramount right now called The Loved Ones. And as of June, folks will be able to go to our site and actually start Tugg events throughout the country. But we're also helping the studios monetize their existing libraries.
So, I mean, getting back to this point of whether it's better to watch in a theater or watching at home, yes, I understand most filmmakers would prefer that people watch it in a theater because that's sort of where it's the best experience. But I think a lot of consumers are agnostic about it, especially now with big screen TVs and the hassle of going out. I think that if you ask them, they might say, well, I'd actually rather just watch this digitally on my on my iPad or in my living room. Is that something that you could evolve into, or you're not really the digital rights involved with that? It's obviously more complicated than what you're doing, but is that something that you're thinking about?
Well, Tugg, as a verb, is an executive interaction platform. We allow people to make decisions as crowds. Mm-hmm. So the way that we're starting to announce theatrical events in theaters, but obviously our goal is to support filmmaking in general. So it could be that, even through what we do in theaters, we're already benefiting the film's performance financially throughout its life cycle. But there are very strong trends, and it's not just Austin, but you have examples like the Alamographers of people that will not go watch a film anywhere except for at the Alamo because it's a destination theater. They won't watch it on DVD. Most people also, when you look at a film like The Tree of Life, would not want to experience any, regardless if you have a 46-inch or 55-inch in your house, nothing compared to actually having access to a 40-foot screen and being able to experience it with people around you that you would like to have experienced it with. And the great thing about Tugg events is, since every single individual in the room is 1 degree or at most two degrees of apart from each other, from social network, the environment is completely different in Tugg events. There's a higher sense of respect for the experience. It's the event itself is something that was collaboratively accomplished through Tugg. So people do embrace this experience in general. We've had Tugg events throughout the country in Ocala stations since November until now. The face of what we call the promoter, who is the individual that kickstarts or starts these events, it could be anyone, it could be a college professor, it could be the Shambhala Center here in Austin, a screen sold out streaming for the Buddhist community in Austin, 50 college streaming with 1,500 friends on Facebook. That face is ever changing. The fact that people want to get together and are using social tools today to decide what they do in the real world is not going to change. It's a trend that is ongoing, and we see Tugg always at the threshold or between the virtual world and the real world as a decision maker.
So I like the idea of mobilization, the event, of calls for people to come together, and I think that's really good. Secondly, we want to open up to the audience as well real quick. We have 3 minutes. There will be an opportunity right now if somebody in the audience has a question or pose a question, so we can also get that exchange going. And my only comment is that going forward, I'd be more interested also in building my own back end and being able to, cloud-based delivering the media myself instead of having to go through these extensive licensing agreements with the with Hollywood and so forth and so on. Original content pipe, cloud-based to every device, potential billion viewers worldwide, mobile devices, handheld devices. So anyway, that's so if I mobilize an audience, I also want to be able to pay off and monetize it that way. Just long term. Anybody have a question?